Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Let's take a look at all of today's Apple announcements. So we got a lot of new products today. Some we expected and some we didn't. So let's start off by looking at the Mac and the release of Mavericks. We all expected there to be something today about the release of Mavericks. Either it would be today or later this week. It turns out it's today. What the big surprise is that not only is it today, but it's free. So Apple went from the $100 plus updates to $10 updates to now Mavericks is free, and you can actually even have Snow Leopard and upgrade all the way to Mavericks with the Mac App Store and do it for free. So that'll be available sometime today, perhaps by the time you see this, at the Mac App Store for you to update. Now, free seemed to be a theme today because Apple also announced updates for all of what were formerly known as iLife and iWork apps. So we're talking about iMovie, iPhoto, GarageBand, Pages, Numbers, and Keynote. Apple announced updates for all of those for both Mac and for iOS and announced that they are now free apps. So you'll be able to download from the Mac App Store and from the iTunes iOS Store for free. And there's some new looks, new features, things we're going to have to look into over the next few days as people play around with these new apps. Also, iWork for iCloud, which are versions of Pages, Numbers, and Keynote on the web, they're going to be new features there too, including collaboration features as well. Now on the Mac hardware side, Apple announced new MacBook Pros, and not only do these have slightly newer specs, but also they have price drops. So now the lower end 13 inch starts at $1,299 and the higher end 15 inch MacBook Pro starts at $1,999. Apple also finally announced pricing for the new Mac Pro and gave us a release window of December. And the new Mac Pro is going to start at $3,000, and that's with a quad-core processor and all the basics. I'm sure it'll go up quite a bit from there. We'll probably see more detailed pricing in the Apple Store website sometime between now and then. And then finally, on the iPad side, as expected, we have new iPads. And like one of the things we expected was that the iPad mini would now have a Retina display, and it does. And a little bit of a price increase to go with that. So it's going to be $400 for the iPad mini with a Retina display. And Apple's going to keep the older iPad mini around at $300. So you can get non-Retina iPad mini with the previous processor in it for $300. For $400 you can get a new one with a Retina display and also the A7 chip. That's the same chip that's in the new iPhone. In addition, the new iPad is going to have that A7 chip in it as well. But what's a big surprise is a change of name. Instead of the fifth generation iPad or just continuing to be called the iPad, it's now going to be called iPad Air to go along with the new thinner design. And these new iPads, well, the iPad Air will be available starting November 1st, which I'm sure there'll be a launch at the Apple stores. The iPad Mini, the new one with the Retina display, will be available later in the month of November. Also, the iPads are going to come in colors now. You're going to be able to get the light colored one, the silver white one, or the dark colored, the space gray slash black one. So you have even more options now. And you have the options just before to get, say, LTE with them and then different memory levels as well. I'm going to keep this short, so if you're looking for details, just go to Apple's website. They'll have all the tech specs for all these things up there, and I'm sure they'll even be pre-ordering for the iPads at some point, and the ordering for the products that are available today, such as the MacBook Pro. Until next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now.